Hello, John Talley here with Partzilla.com. Today we're going to be looking at the top end on our 2003 Honda Rancher 350. Now what's going on with this one? Well, actually when she gets warmed up, it starts to blow out a little bit of blue smoke. So something's going on either with the head or the piston and rings. So what are we going to do? Well, we're going to crank it up, let it warm up, and then we're going to go ahead and do a compression test. That'll kind of give me a baseline as to what's going on with it. After that, we're going to go ahead and pull the plastics off, get the fuel tank out of the way, and then start tearing into the engine itself. So if you're ready, let me go grab a couple of tools and I'll show you how to get it done. All right, this is going to be a skill level 3, but don't be afraid of it. It's not going to be that bad. Let's go over some of the tools that you're going to need to get this pulled apart. First, you want to get a couple of good ratchets, 3/8 and then a quarter inch. You also want to go ahead and get a big breaker bar, because I know from experience that those head bolts are on there pretty tight. Other than that, you'll need a full array of different extensions, whether they're half inch or 3/8 or quarter inch. It'll just make life a lot easier when you're trying to get the ratchets down there to remove the different nuts and bolts. As far as the different sockets you're going to need, you need a range from an 8mm up to about a 14. Beyond that, you're going to need a spark plug socket and then a 6mm Allen. As far as regular wrenches, just need a 10mm and a 14mm. Need a couple of good screwdrivers, flathead and a Phillips, a little bit of a pry bar. Probably going to need that to bring up the cylinder. Other than that, a set of side cutters, set of needle nose pliers, and that'll be good to go on the tools. Now if you would, go ahead and go to our website and reference our exploded diagrams. That'll give you a really good picture of everything that we're going to be taking apart, so you won't leave anything out. So once you have your tools together, and you've got your computer open, and you're looking at that exploded diagram, we can get started. All right, we've got her up to temp. What we're going to do is go and do a quick compression test on it and just see where it stands. Yeah, I'd say we're definitely going to find an issue in here because this plug is jet black with a fair amount of oil on it. So yeah, there's definitely something going on in there. And what we're looking for here is going to be something north of 90 PSI. So what we need to do is hold the throttle open, crank it over about 4 or 5 times, and then see what we got. All right, looks like we settled in at 50, 60, about 65. So evidently there's something going on the inside of that engine. So we're going to go ahead and continue on and get the plastics off, get the fuel tank out of the way, and start bringing it down. Step one, let's go ahead and disconnect the battery. What I'll probably do is just go ahead and remove it all the way, put it on a trickle charger. That way we're absolutely sure that we've got a hot battery when we go to restart. Let's go ahead and get some of this plastic out of the way. As you can tell, this plastic's looking a little bit rough, but that's going to be for a different video. We're not concerned with that right now. Let's get it running right, then we'll make it look better. I'm just using a set of side cutters very carefully just to pull these little plastic rivets out. These things are really inexpensive, so when you get ready to order your parts, don't forget to add this to your basket. Something I haven't mentioned yet is as we start getting to the different sections, you're going to want to start bagging and tagging your different nuts and bolts, because it all seems really easy right now. Everything's just going to come flying apart on the machine. But when it comes time to put it back together, you're going to look at this particular nut or bolt and go, "Now, where did that go?" Well, let's go ahead and get the airbox. You just need to loosen the clamp going to the back of the carburetor and this air induction channel. Then there's a hose going down to the crankcase for its vent, and then there's just one 10mm bolt on the very bottom of the air filter box. You can actually get to it going straight through here, and it's down there at the bottom. I'm going to pull this intake rivet right here, so once we get those, the unit will slide back. We can just lift off the whole thing as an assembly. All right, next, let's go ahead and turn our fuel off. Now we can disconnect our fuel line. You may need to put a drip pan under it, because I would imagine a little bit's going to dribble out. Get these vent lines up and out of the way and get this removed.
Let's go ahead and take off the fuel line. And then there's one electrical connection for the carb heater.
Reach under that edge, this little tab that you can pull up, and then it'll release. Let's loosen up the clamp that goes to the intake boot in the front of the carburetor, and she should just pop right off. After that, grab a 14 millimeter wrench, and we'll take off the choke, and we're gonna pull this cover. It's only one Phillips holding it, and then that'll show the connection to the throttle cable. We can push this little boot up and get a 10 millimeter wrench. Break that loose, and we just unscrew it until it clears. Pull it up through that little channel, bring it around, and she's clear. All right, let's go ahead and get the fuel tank off. Basically, there's just three 10 millimeter bolts holding it in place, two up front, then just one dead center in the back. Actually, I need to go ahead and pull this little handle off because it actually goes through a piece of plastic that goes to the turnoff valve for the tank. That needs to go ahead and get unscrewed and taken out before we can lift it out. Make sure you feed your hose out. Bring it back and lift it out. Good grief, the thing was about full. Next, let's go ahead and get those permanent, if you want to call them zip ties, disconnected, and that'll release all the cables. Then there's a couple of more rivets need to come out, and then we'll lift out this plastic shelf. We are about to open up this engine. So if yours looks worse than this one as far as all the mud and everything around it, get it cleaned up a little bit before we actually open up the engine. I'm just going to clean this up with a wire brush, and then we'll start to get the exhaust off. Go ahead and start pulling the engine down. Starts by just removing the muffler. Basically, you've got two bolts that are attached to the hanging points on the frame itself, and then there's a clamp that you just need to loosen up, and then we should be able to shimmy it off. All right, let's get the head pipe removed. There, and just pull it straight off. All right, we're gonna go ahead and pull the valve cover, and then we're gonna pull an inspection plug down at the bottom, and we're gonna bring it around to top dead center. And the reason I'm doing this first is the only way I can tell if I'm on the compression stroke is to see if there's any tension on the rocker arms. All right, the only way we can get the engine to turn over is to use this recoil starter. And what we're looking for is to bring it around to that timing mark. This is gonna be just a bit tricky. All right, and there it is. Hear that? And that's just set to the tolerances. So that's top dead center on the compression stroke. All right, let's go ahead and remove that top motor mount, which is actually going to the head. A couple of 12 millimeters that go in, and then there's gonna be a 14 millimeter that goes through that the top section, which is the rubber insulated part. I need to go ahead and get these this 10 and this 12 out. All right, before we get those four main head bolts, two 10 millimeter ones on the side, go ahead and get those released. That way, the only thing left holding it down are these four. And what we need to do is bring those off a quarter turn at a time, going in a crisscross pattern, because that's going to relieve all the tension that's holding the head down. All right, we are almost there. I just need to go ahead and pull the intake so it'll clear this cross member on the frame. Not looking too bad, but it's awfully oily in there. Something is letting oil get into the combustion chamber. I'm betting on piston rings at this point, but we will be taking a look at the valves and the seats as well. Let's go ahead and get the jug off and see what she looks like. Carefully reach up under here to see if we can get it to break loose of the base gasket. There we go. Don't pry too hard. You won't want to break off one of the fins on the cylinder. And there's two more dowels down at the bottom. At this point, I highly recommend that you go ahead and get some of your shop towels and place them around the crank area, because it would not be pleasant to drop something in there right now, like a nut or bolt. Let's go ahead and remove one of our wrist pin circlips. That way we can get the wrist pin pushed out and take the piston off. There we go. All right, from the looks of the piston, looks like a fair amount of oil was getting pushed by them. I'm looking in between the rings, so I think that's what we were running up against. Taking a peek at the cylinder itself. It's actually not in that bad a shape. I don't feel a lip or anything down at the bottom of where the piston rings travel. What I have noticed is there's a few wear marks right here
So could I get away with just putting new rings in it? Well, probably. But since we're in here, and honestly the parts aren't really that expensive, I think I'm going to go ahead and bore it probably one or two sizes over. Well, all right, guys, that pretty much wraps this one up. All that's left for me is to get on Partzilla.com and start ordering some parts so we can get this thing put back together. In the meantime, I'm going to go ahead and send off that cylinder, get it bored out. Probably going to go ahead and replace at least the valves and the valve seals. So, if you would, while I'm getting those parts ordered at Partzilla, follow us over to the next video and I'll show you how to begin to put this back together. Until next time, we just want to say thanks for watching.